Alrighty. G'day YouTube. Hello subscribers. Quick video just demonstrating another useful need for homemade coax cable. In this particular case, this is my final amplifier design for 70 centimeters to about 230-240 odd watts. Here I've incorporated the Wilkinson Combiner, the input and output on the one FR4 PCB board. So that's going to be my final design, but prior to making that, I'd done it without the input and output Wilkinson Combiners and actually just used external combiner on both sides. So this was made, homemade, by hand, using the method that I've used previously on re-threading, but in this case I've actually used 75 ohm coax cable of a quad core nature and removed three of the shields and re-threaded it with high quality bray from RG58 and then heat shrunk it over to do that, and that's just 100 ohm resistor there. So let's just see how it performs, and just give you a quick showcase of the amplifier. It's in a rack mount type situation, and so that's the it's a sort of final output looking. That's going to look like that. My supply is at about 27.5 volts, running on two 13.8 volt supplies in series, nothing special there. And just clipping up now. Okay. And the exciter radio is simply a IC208H, one channel 20, mid band, 15 watts into the amplifier. And let's have a look at the output. Go to the calibrate first. Cal, first WR, about 1.2 to 1, and power. Best side of 200 watts, 200 whiskies on 70 sems, a bit higher than 70 sems actually, about 477, so is it 63 centimeters I think they call it, but all that and all. The only issue is my power supply sags in a 22 volts, so if I rectify that, keep that at 27 volts, I should see about 240 watts. Yeah, I should see easy 240 watts. So there you go. A very, very quick demonstration of a very nice, useful application of homemade, custom-made coax cable. Used as a Wilkinson combiner. So hope that's useful, hope that gets some thumbs up, and please do give me a couple, they're always useful, keeps me going, and as always, stay tuned.